here just to welcome you back. We've had people here all week. First of all, thank you for all your support in these last 2 months, 2 months or 9 weeks, whatever it is, 10 weeks. For collection, there's a basket by this door, the door back there, one in Jesuit Hall, and that door back there. So just put your envelope in. The ushers will take care of it after Mass. You're required to wear a mask supposedly coming into church, going out of church, and coming to Holy Communion is suggested. And it's highly suggested if you wear it during the Mass, but some people don't because they can't or physically don't feel they can, but we do ask and keeping everybody else safe. Missalettes are out. If you take one, it's yours. Don't put it back. Bring it back when you come to church next time. There's masks over there. There's bulletins. Take those home. Don't put them back for everybody else's sake. Keep the 6 feet apart. As we said down here, this church and the lower church is 4 individuals to a pew, or 3 couples, or 2 families. And families, if you live together. For communion, it would be the side aisles. You come down the side aisle, there would be one minister here, one minister there, and if we have the other other people are here, we'll have one in the middle and one in the middle in that aisle over there. And you can see there's lines on the floor. We won't talk about Jesuit Hall because I don't think anybody will be in there. But we have space for besides in church, the loft, Jesuit Hall, the choir room, and also the big room upstairs. So we can fit a number of people in church for Mass if they come. After Mass, you're supposed to kind of just keep your distance going out, not creating a crowd. And we thank you for your patience and your understanding, and thanks for being here. Believe it or not, you're probably more people than we had last night at 4:30. Monday we had 70 people here, and then kind of went down during the week. Last night we had like 42. I think there's more people than that here this morning. So, but thanks for being here. And if you have somebody homebound or a family member who's not coming to church, you're permitted to take them communion. We'll give you a pix, and then you can come up when you do that, and we'll give you Holy Communion to take home to somebody. Because we're not going in the homes. I'm going to people's doors, but not people's inside their houses for communion. So, and we're not going to the nursing homes or the hospital yet. So keep the couple of people in your prayers that they ask for prayers too. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Again, welcome back this morning as we give praise and honor to our God this day. Today is the Feast of the Ascension. If you're really familiar with our stained glass windows, you would know which one it is, right? It's the one in the back, right before the choir loft. That's the Ascension of Jesus. And so we'll talk about that today, what it means for the Ascension for us in the church, and what it means, especially with everything going on. We come to give praise and honor to our God, for God has been so good to us. He's really blessed us, and we are very thankful for that. As we come to praise God, we first ask God for forgiveness of our sins.
Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the King and Christ and the Anointed One. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. You sit at his right hand. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us give glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone, the Holy One, you alone, our Lord, you alone, the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Gladden with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving for the ascension of Christ your Son, and is our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theopolis, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He had presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days, and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy,
a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
All you peoples, clap your hands. Shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God mounts his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid trumpet blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
For the King of all the earth is God. Sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him his head over all things to the church, which is his body, in the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. And when they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you, and behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord. Again, this week has been very different for us because we're getting used to having people out there. This Mass is being videoed this morning. It's on Facebook Live right now. And of course, it will be then put onto our website and be on the website for those who are not coming. And again, the Archbishop and the Bishops of the United States have made the proclamation that you don't have to be to church. It's not a moral obligation. We would like, if people can't physically come, to watch it. There's so many ways to do it. We have on our own webpage. You can go on most parishes and find their webpage and have it. even the cathedral, are, as some people watch EWTN because they don't have the internet. There's several masses a day there. So the obligation is not in effect, and who knows when that will be put in effect again, but no obligation for people to attend, physically attend mass, especially if they have health reasons or whatever from that standpoint. And of course, we encourage people, if you have any kind of symptoms of even a cold, not to come from that standpoint. You know, when I think about this whole experience that you and I've had, you know, I'm the longest of the priests here, of course, celebrating 44 years on Friday. And, you know, this is a new experience for everybody. And, you know, we kept on getting dates, you know, like it was basically around March 17th, I think the last day we had school and we had mass here. And then, of course, by that time, by the weekend, I don't think we had mass. And then, you know, we were given a date. Well, we might have mass on this day, and then it come to that day, and then we changed it to another day, you know. And you know you have different levels of government. You have the president saying things. You have the governor saying things. Our commissioner and our county has said things and given dates. And then we have the archbishop, which we have to follow by obedience. And that's one of the things we do at ordination. We put our hands into his hands, and yes, we promise obedience to you and your successors. Cardinal Carberry ordained me, and then I had, of course, Archbishop May and Archbishop Rigali, Cardinal Burke, and now Archbishop Carlson, which one of these days he will retire, so I'll have a new archbishop sometime when he retires. I'll have a new archbishop to be obedient to. And so we have all these levels, and so, you know, it gets confusing, you know. I remember, you know, going down to the river. I try to walk every day. I either walk out to Lions Lake and around and back, or I go down to the New Western Trail down to the river, down to the St. John's Creek. And it's like a party down there. And so what they did, they put up the barriers so nobody could go on the riverfront. And then, you know, they were going to open up on Monday. Well, they took the barriers on Friday night down, you know, so people could go down there. You know, all these kind of restrictions, all these kind of, you know, what can we do, what can we not do, what we should do. You know, it's even like in church, you know, we've asked people to wear a mask. Some people don't. Right after Mass, one of our maintenance men will clean the entire church and sanitize it. He'll come back after 9 and do the same. After 11, he'll do the same. And then if you come at 1 o'clock this afternoon, there's actually a place like you do at the gym. You're supposed to clean your own spot if you come back tonight or this afternoon, or if you come back after church and any day during the week. You're supposed to clean your own spot, sanitize it. You know, all these different things. How confusing, right? Think of the apostles and their confusion. First of all, when we have read, you know, we've listened, you know, even before, during the Easter season and before, one of the Gospels, when they talk about Jesus and his disciples, and when he starts preaching about communion, about eating his body and drinking his blood, one of the comments of the scripture says, how many people went away? They could not accept his teaching. But then you figure out all these other stories, you know, all the other things that build upon that. You think about the whole road to Calvary, which we have in the Stations of the Cross. That's only John and Mary and a couple of the ladies that were at the crucifixion. Peter denied him 3 times. Judas committed suicide because he couldn't deal with his embarrassment of turning Jesus over. And so it's like, because their expectation was that Jesus, you know, was this, he was the anointed one, that means Christ, but he was the one that's going to come to save them. He was going to be their savior. And how did they figure? He was going to be a political ruler. He was going to make Israel great again. And he didn't do that. He died. So Peter even went back to fishing. Well, what else am I supposed to do? I don't know fishing. I'll go back to being a fisherman. And then you have the resurrection on Easter. He appears to the women, and even Peter and John, they run to the tomb, and John, being younger, gets to the tomb first, looks in, but waits for Peter to come and to go into the tomb. And, you know, they're trying to believe what now he rose from the dead. What does that? And then Jesus comes and he eats fish with them on the shore. He does all these kind of things to prove to them that he is alive, that he came back to life. And he spends these 40 days, you know, that we call this Easter season, to prove that he has risen. And then you come to today, and he says, goodbye, I'm leaving. If you've been to Mass this week, or if you've listened to the scripture readings and looked at them, Jesus keeps on saying, I got to leave, I got to leave, I got to leave. I got to go so the Spirit can come. And it's like, Spirit? You're going to leave? You're going to leave us? What are we going to do? And we even have that period between the Ascension and Pentecost, which is next Sunday, them being bewildered. They even locked themselves into a room before, and they just don't know what to do. He says, don't leave. They were completely bewildered. And that's what we, in a sense, but Jesus had to go through these different stages, and he goes to the stage today to sit at the right hand of the Father. He intercedes for us. You know, how many times I know I have been asked in my years of priesthood of people asking favors for somebody else. Would you do this for my my parents? Would you do this for my son? Would you do this for my cousin? Always people interceding. How many of us maybe asked our mother to ask our father for something? We went through her. Which is what we do with Mary and Jesus and the Father. But Jesus reminds us that he and the Father are one, but he had to leave in order to send us the Spirit, because that's the completion of initiation. And that's why confirmation is so important in our lives, completing our sacraments of initiation, of being fully incorporated into the church with the Father, Son, and Spirit. Because we become children of God at baptism. So today is complete. We're continuing our physical journey during this. But what we were feeling is the same kind of feeling from a different way that the apostles felt on a day like today. They had faith. We need to have faith. And we need to share that faith with one another. Because some people's faith is not as strong maybe as ours. Are they bewildered? Are they lost? And we are to witness that, because that's what Jesus called all of us to do, that gospel, to go out and baptize, to go out and bring people to the Lord, to witness to Christ. That's what you and I are supposed to do every day, by words, actions, and deeds.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all that is visible and invisible. I believe one Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is adored and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the body and life for the world to come. Amen. Heavenly Father, as we gather, we offer these prayers of petition.
For the church, that empowered by the Spirit, we may faithfully give witness to the gospel and continue Christ's mission of bringing hope and healing to those in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who serve in public office, that the Holy Spirit continue to guide them in their decisions and deliberations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are fearful or anxious, that they may recognize God's message, "Fear not," is for them, and allow God to calm their spirits and give them hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who feel alone and isolated, that God will console them, let them experience God's presence in their homes, and help others to connect with them to maintain the community spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Christopher Smith and Father Dane Westhoff, who were ordained to the priesthood on Saturday, may the Lord bless and protect them in ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Archbishop Carlson, Father Tony, and Father Mike, who are all celebrating their anniversaries of ordination to priesthood, that the Holy Spirit continue to guide and protect them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, particularly those with COVID-19, that God's healing spirit will fill them, ease their pain, and restore them to wholeness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Reverend Robert L. Hymos and Sister Laurette Haberberger, sister-in-law of Betty Haberberger, because of virus and all who died recently, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bring to the Lord now our own personal intentions. We pray especially for the people of this parish for whom this Mass is being offered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. On this Memorial Day weekend, let us pray for all our veterans and for all those who've died to defending our country to give the rights that we have and the privileges. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we give you praise and honor for this day. We thank you for your graces. We ask for your fatherly care. We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus Christ, King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of the following, where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection. And to you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may gather into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Robert our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, including St. Francis Borgia and St. Louis, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ has said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen."
May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy, should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Have a spiritual communion at this time. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there. Unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us continue with our prayer. Almighty and ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you through Christ our Lord. Amen. In case you didn't recognize the names that we had of the deceased, Father Hymos was the pastor of Lourdes, and he built the church over there, so he's like two pastors away, or three, or whatever it was, when he was there. He didn't die of the virus at all, because he had COPD from all his lighting up his cigarettes for his life. And then we had sister who died, it was Betty Haberberger's sister-in-law. We've had six priests die of the virus at Regina Clary. Every priest, all 25 or 27, all had the virus. There's still a number of them in the hospital, so keep them in your prayers also from Regina Clary. And everybody else, there's people struggling financially. Two people are losing their jobs, they're furloughing their jobs. I know we've heard a lot of people from Mercy recently. So there's a lot of people who need our prayers. So thanks for all you do. Thanks for whatever you can do. And the only other announcement we have is Deacon Leon's trying to reorganize the day of adoration on Tuesdays from after Mass till 8 p.m. at night. So he's calling people, or if you want to volunteer for an hour during the day, just up to 8 o'clock at night, welcome to call him or email him or whatever. It's in the bulletin. So he's trying to reorganize that on Tuesdays. Have a great day and have a safe weekend, this Memorial Day weekend. The Lord be with you.
And with yours.
May Almighty God bless you all in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let this be known.